Hello everyone, Danielle here, and welcome to another video. Today I am going to talk about something that is a bit of a misconception in the whole screaming and growling community, or many people think it's a big misconception, and it is about the connection between the Fry vocals and the Fry screams and growls. Many people think that it's really unsafe, and it's actually a misinformation to start and try to do a Fry scream from the Fry vocal technique. Let me dive into it a little bit more and I'll tell you my opinion, and after that you can form your own and start practicing in a way that it feels comfortable for you. So, first of all, yes, I have taught many people and many of my students to try to use the Fry vocal technique to create their basic Fry, screams and growls. However, it is a basic technique, so I am not saying this is the only way to create the Fry scream or the Fry growl. It is one of the many ways that you can create, and you can try to use Fry vocal technique for it. In the past, if I have said in a shorter video that how to use the Fry vocal technique to create a Fry scream, I usually said that you can just try to go on with the Fry vocal technique and build it up from there. And I still think that is a valid point. However, you should know that the Fry vocal technique, the Fry singing technique, is not the basis of the Fry scream and growls. It's not the basis of the Fry screams and growls. It is a way to create the Fry distortion, which is the basis of the Fry scream and growls. So do not think about the Fry vocal techniques as a basis for that whole technique. Think of it as a tool to use, as a way to try to reach the Fry distortion. What is the Fry distortion? What is the Fry distortion and what is the Fry vocal, basically? Fry vocal technique, if you don't know, is basically the sound that your true vocal cords do when they are pushed together and the two of them are next to each other, and as the breath, the air comes through the vocal cords, it creates a crackling sound that sound that, you know, you hear when basically the door opens slowly or something. This is a valid technique that singers use when they are trying to reach sounds from a deeper note, from a lower note. So when they sing like, "And I..."
And who are you, the proud Lord said, that I must bow so low? Only a cat.
Fry distortion, on the other hand, is the basis of the Fry scream and Fry growls. It is the sound when your false chords and also do the work in order to create the distortion sound that we use in as extreme vocalists. However, your true vocal cords do not actually do the work. They don't actually have pressure on them. It is a sound like, as you can hear, it's a much more airy and much more dirtier, distorted sound than a Fry vocal sound. The reason that you cannot really use the Fry vocals as a basis is because you cannot make the Fry vocal sound louder. It's just the sound that you do when you are speaking like this. Fry distortion on the end can be used if you are doing like vocals and you try to distort your sound in different ways. Even when you sing, something like this. Is it dangerous to use Fry vocals to reach Fry distortion? In my opinion, no. However, without the proper guidelines, you can use it in a bad way. The whole idea of creating Fry distortion, Fry screams out of a Fry vocals came from teachers like Extreme Vocal Institute and Melissa Cross and Sing and Scream. All of them made it popular, and they have a valid point. I still think that, but some key things are only said in different videos, and if you go into deeper it, you'll understand that the Fry vocal is somewhere around the same place as you would create the Fry distortion. However, your vocal cords, like I said before, don't do pressure. They don't have pressure on them. They don't do the work. How I tell my students is that when you do the Fry distortion sound, your false chords are actually, it's more like a visualization, but imagine it that it's pressed next to the true vocal folds and the true vocal cords, and they give a support to the vocal cords. The true vocal cords do this kind of sound. If you let that sound go and try to tighten your false chords and tighten your throat, basically, like if you would push the air out in a way that you are trying to whisper very loudly. If you're whispering very loudly, you're basically Fry screaming really, really quietly. So if you do that and push through the vocal, Fry vocal sound, something like a Fry distortion should happen. Your true vocal cords and folds let go of that Fry vocal sound, and the false chords and are supporting your true vocal cords, and the false chords are doing the work. And this is how the Fry distortion are created. And from there on, you can create different types of sounds like that is the basic principle on the connection between Fry vocals and Fry distortion. The key phrase is to remember that the Fry vocal is not exactly the basis of the Fry scream, growls, and the Fry distortion. It is a tool that you can use to reach the Fry distortion sound, which is the basis of the Fry scream and Fry growl sound. If you want to learn more about this, I have an online vocal course up on Udemy and Skillshare. Here I only posted about one of the first videos about doing a Fry scream, which talks about how to reach from a Fry vocal technique. But if you want to get into it more deeply on how to use the Fry vocal and other techniques to reach the Fry distortion, then check out my website, check out my course, write to me for a private lesson. And until then, I see you next video. Metal!